So Bezat Hashem, we're starting Daf Lamed Bet.
That's great.
Tana Rabanan. No. Okay. Bishlama Lirbi Meir, who says that you do two kiddushes by the first. You have five tevilot. The first one you're dipping from your regular clothes to the big day. To the big day kehuna. Right? So you have five tevilot. If you need two kiddushim by each tevilah, so you get 10. Masha'enkin, according to the Chachamim, that say that the first kiddush is for taking off the clothes, and by the first dipping, since he's taking off b'gdei atzmo, he doesn't need a kiddush. So it comes out that four tevilot need two kiddushes. The first one only needs one. So if I count them up, what do I get to? Nine.
Actually, eight, no,
because
the last one's
big day asma. Nine.
The last one's not
big day asma? No. Bishlam al Rabbi Meir, Hainu Dimashka Hala, Asara Kiddushin, Rashi Lahamesh Tevilot, El Rabbanan, Tesh Ahavu, Dehasra Le Tevilari Shona, Had Kiddush, Amri Lecha Rabbanan, the Chachamim will tell you, Kiddush Batra, Kipatshit, Big Day Kodesh, Velavish, Big Day Hol Avid Le. Says, yeah, but when the guy's going to get undressed to put on his own clothes, no tevilah, because he's not going to Kodesh, but he's putting on his own clothes. He has to wash his hands before he takes off the big day Kodesh. All right, if I hold that you always have to wash your hands before you take off the big day Kodesh, so, like you said, but there's no tevilah there. When I take off the big day Zahav to go home, I have to wash my hands, but there's no tevilah because I'm not putting on anything. So according to the Bimeir, it's neat. It's two per tevilah, 5 and 10. According to the Chachamim, it's 1, 8, and 1.
Better.
Kipashi big de kodesh velavish big de hol avi lehat.
1, 8, 1.
Tan Rabbanan. Tan Rabbanan, Uba Aharon Elohel Moed. Now, truth is, Eli, bring the Chumashi, the hot spot one for everybody. Uba Aharon Elohel Moed. Lema Uba. What's he coming for? What is this pasuk? Uba Aharon Elohel Moed. Open up Parashat Aharemot. When Eli comes, I'll tell you what page it is. Bezot yavo Aaron el Kodesh bepar ben bakar lehatad ve'ayel le'ola. I got one hand. Right, bepar lehatad ve'ayel le'ola. Ketonet bat Kodesh ilbash. Now, there's a couple of things you got to remember as we're going through. This pasuk is one of them. We're going to need it soon. Ketonet pasuk dale. Ketonet bat Kodesh ilbash. Umichnes evad. You al bisaro, ubeavnet bad yitznof, big de kodeshem, verahatz b'mayim et bisaro uvesham. Right? So you see that before you put on the clothes, you need tevilah. Umeet adab b'nei yisrael yikach, shene se'ire ezim lehata, v'ay lehal le'ola, v'ekriv aharon et parahatata shelo, v'chiper ba'ado ba'ad beto. Right? So this is the start of the avodat tayom. Rani, pass me the tissues. Right, this is the beginning of the avodat hayom. Meaning, you have the avodat. The avodat every day he's doing before this. He's doing the tamid shel shachar before this. He's doing all that stuff before that. Now, v'rahatz b'mayim et b'saro uvesham, he's going to get dressed into the bigdei lavan. So now, what's he doing? V'kriv aron et parahatata shelo v'chiper ba'do ba'ad beto is what? 638. That's vidui. V'lakachet shene asirim v'emid otam lefnei Hashem petach ol moed. That's the shene asirim, one lazel, one Hashem. V'natan Aaron al shene asirim goralo. Goral echal Hashem, goral echal lazel. That's when he's choosing which one becomes what. He's not doing anything. He's just making the goral. V'ekriv Aaron et asair asher ala alav ul Hashem v'asau hatat. How does he make it a hatat? By putting the goral on it. V'asair, you could learn v'asau hatat means shechted, but it's not what he's doing yet. והסעיר אשר עלה עליו הגורל לעזאזל יעמוד חי לפני השם. I think so. Yeah, right. That's what I said. וחבר שלו עזאזל המדברה. והקריב אהרון את פרה חטאתה שלו. V'chiper ba'ado ba'beto. Now he's very mechaper. So this v'chiper is also for the Kohanim. That's the second vidui that the Kohen Gadol makes on the par. V'shachat et parahatata shelo. Now he finally makes the shechita. V'lakach me'lo ha'machta. Now after the shechita.
That was all zahav.
No, this is all b'gedal avan. He still hasn't changed out of it yet. V'lakach me'lo ha'machta gacha le'esh me'al ha'mizbech me'lefnei Hashem. So he shechted the pot. It didn't say what to do with the blood. Now, go take him. Right? Here's the machloket with the tzdukim. Clearly, he's inside when he's putting it on, right? Now, so it doesn't say, but he clearly has to go back outside. Get the dam apart. Vizabes bo penah kapora kedma. That's a hadle mala. Lefneh kapora yaze sheva pa'amim. That's sheva limata. Min adam v'shachat zira hatata shel ha'am. Again, he goes out. Shech zira hatat. Vevi damo mibe la paroga. V'asun kasheh asla dam par. Ala kapora. Up lefneh kapora. Down. V'chiper ala kodesh. Min kubanei smashem. Chen yaseh lomer. Meaning go out and sprinkle on the parochet. וכול אדם לא יבא ומועל בבואו לחפר בקודש עצתו וחיפר בעדו בעד ביתו בעד כל קהל ישראל ויצא למזבח אשר לפני השם meaning go out to the מזבח הזהב וחיפר עליו ולקח מדם הפר ומדם הסעיר he mixes them together ונתן על קרנות המזבח סביב ויזה עליו מן אדם באצבעו שבע פעמים ותיארו וקדשו מתאומה מזהו וחילה מחפר את הקודש ולמועד ואת המזבח והקריב את הסעיר החי that's the עזאזל ושמח אהרון שתי ידיו על ראש הסעיר החי ודוודה עליו את כל so he's still in בגדי לבן he didn't have to change it's all עבודת היום right ודוודה עליו את כל עוונו בני ישראל וכל פשעים כוחתם ונתם ראש של חי ושלמי המדברה ונעשה הסעיר לכל עוונותם אל ארץ כזירה ושלח תסעיר במדבר now this pasuk is what we're discussing ובא אהרון אלו מועד ופשט את בגדי הבד אשר לבש בבואו לקודש וניחם שם what's he going to the Olam Moed for? To change? You have a better place to change than inside the Moed? Hey, nobody's there, like we said. You hang the old Begadim on the poles of the Shulchan, you put the new ones on the poles of the Mizbeach, and you have a very clean, it's like a very guy place thing, right? Take your jacket off, you put it on the chair. What's he doing? So that's the question. What's he going into the old Moed for? Now.
Is the first time he's changing his clothes?
Yeah. It's not. It said he changed. It said that you put on the Big Day Zahav, the Big Day Lavan. So that means that he already put on the Bigdei Zahav, took off the Bigdei Zahav, put on the Bigdei Lavan. Now it says he goes into the Moed. So what's he going in for? The Gemara is going to say that he goes in to take out the Kaf and the Machta. You have remnants over there. You have stuff left there. So go back in and take it out. Good. Right? V'rachat et besaro b'mayim b'makom kadosh. Which is his begadav? Now again, you see when he's changing clothes, there's a tevilah here, right? V'lavashet begadav. V'yatza ve'asa et olato ve'et olat ha'am. So if he's putting on begadav, it can't mean his own clothes. Why? Because he's doing korbanot. So which is begadav? The Bigdei Zahav. Right? V'chiper v'ado v'ad ha'am. V'etchele v'chatat yaktir mizbeach. This is all wrap up. V'amshalech daz yachabes b'gadav v'rachab z'mohayim v'achar ken yavol ha'machane.
What? The first Rashi brings that
we're getting there. V'etpar ha'chatat v'etzich daz yon zam yisri b'chus ha'machane v'asref otam. Doesn't say any more avodah. So Gemara says, Tan Rabbanan. Uba Aharon Elol Moed Lemahuba. What's he coming for? Enoba Elalo Tzieta Kaf Veta Machta. He's going in to take out the Kaf and the Machta. That's one point. So you say, Rashi, Uba Aharon Elol Moed Ne'emar Ahar Shegamar Haktara. ומתן דמים פר וסעיר. למה הוא בא להיכל? הרי גמר עבודתיו. אף במקרא זה לא פירש מה יעשה לשם. He doesn't say what to do. אין הוא בא אלו להוציא כף ומחתה שהניח בין הבדים כדכתיב ונתן את הקטורת על האש. You left it there, it fills up the room. You go out. You gotta clean up your mess. אוקיי, סז גמרא, כל הפרשה כולה נאמרה לסדר, חוץ מפסוק זה. The whole parasha is said in order. One thing after the other, בדיוק. To the point where, like we said, he shechts the dam apar, he shechts the par, you go do the ketoret, you come back out, and you get the dam apar, even though it seems like a funny order. You shechted it, then you do ketoret in the middle one. Everything is exact. Chutz mi mikra zeh. My ta'ama, what's the reason? How do you know this pasuk is out of order? Makes a lot of sense. Go in there, take him out, and then finish up what you're doing. Says Gemiri, Amar of Chizda Gemiri, we have a halacha la Moshe Misinai. Chamesh tevilot v'asara kiddushin tovel kol gadol mekadesh bo bayom. He has to dip 5 times. V'i kesidran. But if this pasuk is in order, lo mashkach alehu ela shelosh tevilot v'shisha kiddushin, you're only going to need 3 tevilot. Why? Because if he's going to go in at the same time that he's wearing the Bigdei Lavan from all the Avodot, so what happens is he has to go to the mikveh before he puts on the Bigdei Zahav. Finish the Avodat Hayom, go to the mikveh, put on the Bigdei Lavan. Do the whole Avodat Hayom, including cleaning up and taking the stuff out. Go to the mikveh, put on the Bigdei Zahav, and do the Tamid Shoben Arbayin.
No, he washes first.
3 tevilot. Al Korchach, this Hotza'at Takaf is not now. It's after he does something else. So he'll do Tamid Shel Shachar, dip Bigdei Zahav, dip Bigdei Lavan, do the Avodat Hayom, dip, do something else, dip Bigdei Lavan to take out the Kaf and the Machtar, dip Bigdei Zahav for Tamid Shel Ben Arbaim, and then put on your own clothes. Now I have 5.
What? Third time would be Bigdei Lavan also? I mean, after you're wearing Bigdei Lavan, you have Avodat Hayom.
You dip, you put on Bigdei Zahav.
So it's always
do something, we'll see. You never dip from Bigdei Lavan to Bigdei Lavan, it's silly. Just go back in. Rashi. Shekol HaParasha.
That's Pasuk Kaf Dalet, that belongs to Kaf Gimel?
What do you mean?
In our part, when it says the Rahat, the Bissarot belongs to the Machta, or?
No, we'll see. Let's make the difference. Let's see. Shekol HaParasha ne'emru ha-mikraot al seder ha-avodot ha-mitchalfot kesedran be-parasha. The way it is in the parasha, kach seder avodatam. Chutz mi-mikra zu. Shekatav hotza'at kaf u-machta im avodot ha-penimiot, along with the inside avodot. V'lo efsik avodat elo ve-el ha-am. It didn't put the doing, right, in the beginning of the parasha, you almost don't notice. But he says, Bepar ben Bavkar lehatad ve'ay le'ola. Right? Ume'et adat b'nese yikach, shenese irizim lehatad ve'ay leha le'ola. So he's bringing an ayil, and b'nei Yisrael are bringing an ayil. Those two ayils, he's going to bring. What? It says. It says. It says. Ve'asa et olato ve'et olat ha'am. Rashi says et olato ve'ayel le'ola ve'et olat ha'am ve'ayel le'hal le'ola ha'amur le'mala. So he says, doesn't say, bintayim, vayalo luchtov v'tchila, it should have said, v'yatza, v'asa et olato v'et olat ha'am, v'acharkach hu ba haron lo tzikach v'machta, v'acharkach hu pasha the Bigdei Abad, v'nicham sham, because that's really the last time that he's wearing the Bigdei Abad. V'rachatze b'sarov, b'mayim v'lavash b'gadim, shemoneh kol b'gadav, which is, why is it called Bigadav? Hare, the other ones are Bigadav. And neither of them are really Bigadav because they're all Bigdei Kodesh. It says, Shmoneh Shel Kol HaShana. So they call Bigadav because that's what he normally wears. Ve'asa musafim ve'tamid shel ben arbayim.
What Shmoneh?
Shmoneh Bigadim. That's why they call Bigadav. Right? Ma'i ta'ama tzarich lafsik ve'elo ve'el ha'am ben avodat hayom lo tzad kaf u'machta. Amar of Chizda gmiri we have alakha la Moshe Misinai chamesh tevilo bo bayom. If it's in order, right? ואימהם המוספים ותמיד שובן הארבעים. הרי I'm doing everything. I'm doing the whole tail end of the עבודה in one shot. לפיכך, in order to get to what I know is ההלכה למשה מסיני, which is חמש תבילות, צריך להפסיק אלו ואל העם בין עבודת היום להוצאת כף ומחתה. It must be the אלו and אל העם is separating between the עבודת היום and the הוצאת כף ומחתה. והוצאתן, תפסיק בין, והוצאתן תפסיק בין אלו ובין העם לתמיד שמן ארבעים. And taking about it, מפסיק between the אלו and אל העם, which is in בגדי זהב, and the תמיד שמן ארבעים is also in בגדי זהב. But I had to put on בגדי לבן to go back into the קודש קודשים. הרי חמש, רשי, listen, תמיד של שחר בבגדי זהב, עבודת היום בבגדי לבן, אלו ואל העם בבגדי זהב, על המזבח החיצון, הוצאת כף ומחתה בבגדי לבן ומוספים ותמיד של בין הבאים בבגדי זהב. Good. Says the Gemara, Amar, Tanya, Amar Biuda, מנין לחמש תבילות. Now, if you remember, in the parasha, we had two places where it mentioned dipping. Right? Between the bigadim. You have in the beginning of the parasha, it says, ketonet bad kodesh ilbad. Pasuk dalet. Umichnes evad yu al besaro. Ubavnet bad yachgor. Umevsever bad yitznof. Bigde kodeshem. Verachatz vamayim et besaro vesham. Right? That's one pasuk. And then you have the tail pasuk. You have ובא אהרון אלו מועד ופשט את בגדי הבד אשר לבש בו קודש ורחץ את בשרו במים במקום קדוש ולבש את בגדיו. So you have two פסוקים of dipping. One by changing into the בגדי זהב, לבן, in the beginning, and one changing into the בגדי זהב at the end. So Tanya אמר
ביהודה,
דאורייתא.
So why did the Chazal say this? לכן פשוט מסיים.
Because it only says twice. ברוך הבא, רבי. ברוך השם. כן, תודה רבה. זה בא מהארץ, זה טוב.
בארץ
יש לזה. תנא רבנן. Let's go back. תניא, אמר ביהודה, מניין לחמש תבילות ועשרה קידושים שטובעו כמגבו ביום, תמוד לומר, ובא אהרון אל אוהל מועד, the second פסוק. ופשט את בגדי הבד, ורחץ את, he's skipping the end, ורחץ את בשרו במים במקום קדוש, ולבש את בגדיו ויצא, ועשה. הלמדת, בניין אב, בניין אב, שכל המשנה מעבודה לעבודה, טעון תבילה. Whenever you're changing types of בגדים, עבודת העבודה, you need a תבילה. So even though it's only talking over here, after the עבודת היום, going into בגדי זהב, who are they going into בגדי זהב, going out of בגדי זהב, הכל אותו דבר. That's Rabbi Yehuda. Rashi says, "Me'avodah la'avodah, me'avodat pinim la'avodat chutz." Wadim mechutz lepnim. Ulkaman mesayim milta. Later on, they're going to finish it up. Ve'katani hamesh avodot havu hare hamesh tevilot. Ketonet Amar Rabbi. Rabbi says, "Minayin lehamesh tevilot va'asara kedushin shetovel kohen gadol mekdesh bovim shneimar." ketone bad kodesh ilbash umichnes bad yoav besaro vavne bad yachkom yosef bad yosof bigde kodesh hem verachatz vamayim et besaro vesham halamadta you learned shekol mishaneh me'avoda la'avoda ta'on tevila. So Rabbi takes the first pasuk and he makes it a binyan av and he says anytime you put on, you change bigadim, you have to go to the mikveh. Right, one's learning from the A pasuk, one's learning from the B pasuk. Ve'omer bigde kodesh hem. The Gemara is going to explain why we need this ve'omer. Usually when there's omer, it means there's a problem on my limud, and this is coming to answer that. It's the bright. This is all the bright. We didn't comment yet. The Gemara is going to start commenting on the bottom of the amud. Rashi, ketone bad kodesh ilbash, ורחץ במים, הרי כשהוא משנה מעבודת התמיד להתחיל בעבודת היום, because that's what he's doing. He finished the תמיד, and now he's going to start עבודת היום, שהיא פנימית, כדכתי בתרי ולקח את שני עשירים וכו לעניינה. ואומר בגדי קודשם, meaning בתוך מקרא זה עצמו, at the end of this פסוק, לדרוש, יש לך שלוש תיבות הללו, שהן יתרות כולן, ולכמה מפרש, מה הדרשה, what do I need it for? Vech, now we're explaining how do I know that there's five tevilot. V'chamesh avodot en, there's five avodot. Tamid shel shachar bebigdei zahav. Avodat hayom bebigdei lavan. Elo ve'elaam bebigdei zahav. Kaf u'machta, meaning hotzaat kaf u'machta bebigdei lavan. What? You see, the Torah said you have to forgo him. Right? Tamid shel ben arvayim bebigdei zahav. U'minayin. Minayin shekol tevilah ve'tevilah. Tziricha shnei kiddushin. Cleaning up God's house is an avodah. Rashi used to clean the aron with his father with the beard. He used to clean it. Tamud lomar, we do the avodah yedei nochrim. Tan rabbanan. Tan rabbanan. Minayin. How do we know? So now we got five tevilot, right? We have five tevilot because we have either pasuk A or pasuk B. Right? Uminayin, how do I know shekol tevilah v'tevilah tziricha shnei kiddushin? How do I know that every tevilah needs two kiddushes? Tamud lomar, now this is the B pasuk. Upashat v'rahatz v'rahatz v'lavash. Right? That's the pasuk in, what is it, Chavdalet? Right? Kav Gimel. Uba Aaron el ol moed, upashat et begdei abad asher lavash. So we learn in Ke'ilu that Upashat is written on Verahat, on Upashat and on the Velavash. That's where they go. Upashat Verahat Verahat Velavash. Look at Rashi. Tamud Lomar Upashat Verahat. Hach Milta Rabbi Ka'amarla. This that you're learning the Big Day, that you're learning the Kiddush Adayim Veraglayim from Upashat Velavash has to be Rebbe. Why? Rebbe learns the Tevilot from Keton and Bat Kodesh Yilbash. So the Pasuk Upashat Verahatz is extra. I don't need that for Tevilot. So according to Rebbe, Verahatz doesn't mean Tevilah. Verahatz means Kiddush Yadayim Veraglayim. And Upashat Verahatz Verahatz Velavash is going on both.
Boy, his thing says Verahatz B'mayim. This pasuk.
Yes. We're rash with them. Hach milta Rebbe ka'amar la. Digamar tevilot mi verahat v'amayim dechtiv bebigde lavan. V'aytir lehaikira derbiuda. He has this pasuk extra v'darash lekidushin. Now Rashi tells you what Jack's bothered. Upasha v'rahat v'rahat v'lavash. Where do you get two rahats? It only says rahats once. Hitila katu v'rahat ben upashat v'lavash. Liten rechitza lepeshita v'rechitza lelevisha. To teach you that each one gets one. Says the Gemara, Rabbi Eliezer Rabbi Shimon Omer, no, I don't learn it from that pasuk. Kal v'chomer. Uma b'makom she'en ta'on tevila. Ta'on kiddush, when you don't need to go to the mikveh. You have to wash, meaning a regular guy on a regular day. That's coming in. That means all right, he doesn't have to wash. Doesn't need to be lost. He still needs kiddush adayim v'raglayim. Makom sheta'un tevilah oviyan yom kippur en odin sheta'un kiddush. Ima lehalan kiddush echad. The regular kohen, he only has to wash his hands once. Right? Av kan kiddush echad. Tamud lomar, uba aron upashat et begde abad asher lavash. Upashat ebegde abad asher lavash. Ma tamud lomar asher lavash. Kelum adam poshet elam asher lavash. What do you think? You should take him clothes that he didn't put on? Ela lakish peshita lelevisha. So compare the peshita to the levisha. Ma levisha ta'on kiddush, ach peshita ta'on kiddush. So I learned that I know levisha needs kiddush because b'makom she'en ta'on tevila ta'on kiddush. So now I'm going to learn that Pishut also needs. So I have.
What's the custom of Pishut? You're going to do something.
That's why we have Ekesh. We have Ekesh to tell you that Pishita also needs a Gyushet Amir Alayim. By Chok. Rashi. Ma makom she'en ta'on tevila. Kol yemot teshana o yelong yeroni tevila. Ma la'avod en ta'on tevila min ha-Torah. Ela midvrei sofrim, leskor tumah yishana. Maybe it's all leskor tumah yishana. Okay. Ta'on kiddush dechtiv bebo'am elohel moed uvkorvatam elo mizbeach yirchatzu. Makom sheta'on tevila, we need tevila, v'yom ha-kippurim lekol halifo begadim. And then we have the kesh. Ma levisha ta'on kiddush? Tenafka la mikav ha-homet tevila. Umi Pashav Rahat, Lo Darish Rebelezer Bribishum, why is it not like Rabbi? Shetaun Kiddushun, Temi Bayalei Lechalif Bibigadim Kid Rabbi Yudah.
He holds like Rabbi Yudah that I learned the Tevilah from there. So I can't learn it from Rabbi, but I could just learn this Kalvahomer, a Kalvahomer, and a Hekesh.
Tosfot asks a question. Look in Tosfot. Should we confuse you or should we continue? Confused anyway. Okay. Comes out according to this. According to the Beliezer Rabbi Shimon, it comes out that I learned the Kiddush of Levisha from a Kalvahomer. And I learned the Kiddush of Peshita from a Hekesh. Right? Vim Tomar, Valavisha Gufa Bekalvahomer. You only got Levisha from a Kalvahomer. Ubayahi Beperekezel Mekoman. The Gemara has a question. Leman de Amar, Vatar Melamed Azlinan, Idavara Babe Kalvahomer, Hoser Velamed Behekesh Bekadashim.
If you got something from a Kalvahomer, could you then go take it out somewhere else with a Hekesh? It's a question in the Gemara.
Why don't we clear it from here? It's only about Kadashim, that question. When we're talking Kadashim, we mean the actual Hakravat HaKorban, not the accessories of the Kohen getting dressed. Okay. Now we're going to go back. Amar Biuda. Like Amar Mor. Yeah, betfus, maraven betfas, amar mor, amar viuda. Minayin lechamesh tevilo v'asara kiddushin shetovel bo bayom. Kohen gadol mekadesh bo bayom. Tamud lomar, uba Aaron elo moed v'rachatzet besaro b'mayim b'makom kadosh.
Halamata, we learn from that pasuk, which says that when he's changing from bigdei lavan to bigdei zahav, he needs to go to the mikveh.
Shekol meshane ma'avoda la'avoda ta'un tevila. Says the Gemara, Ashkahan mi'bigdei lavan le'bigdei zahav. Right now I only see that you need it when you change it from bigdei lavan to bigdei zahav. Mi'bigdei zahav le'bigdei lavan minayin. How do I know if I go the other way that I have to dip? Tana deber b'Yishmael kalvahomer. No, it's a kalvahomer. Uma ma'bigdei zahav she'en kohen nechnas b'em b'lefnai v'lefnim.
The Bigdei Zahav, they're lower level. How do I know they're lower level? Because the Kohen Gadol can't wear them into the Kodesh HaKodeshim. Ta'un Tevila, you have to wash, you have to dip for putting them on. Bigdei Lavan, Shenichnas Bahem Lefnai V'Lefnim, that he goes into the Kodesh HaKodeshim.
And Odin Shen Ta'un Tevila, of course you're going to need Tevila before you put them on.
Sounds good to Jack.
Ikele Mifrach.
No,
there's a pircha on it. Smaller because there's a hav sheken kaparata meruba.
They mechaper all year long. They're permanent kedusha.
Gemarashi. She mishamesh b'hem kol yemot hashana. Avol avodat penim diyom haKippurim ena mechaperet el al tumat mikdash v'kadashav.
Of course they have. Of course they're kadosh. They're kadosh.
Ela nafkalei made the Rebbe. He learns it from Rebbe. What's Rebbe? He learns it from the other pasuk. Ketone bad kodesh ilbash v'rahatz b'mayim ulvesham.
Said no. That Rebbe's pasuk is talking when you machlif from Bigdei Zav to Bigdei Lavan. And this pasuk is talking when I'm being machlif from Bigdei Lavan to Bigdei. According to Biuda right now, I have two pesukim. One for switching from Bigdei Zav to Bigdei Lavan. I need dipping. One from switching from Bigdei Lavan to Bigdei Zav. I have dipping.
Which one's holy moment? Switching from gold.
They both. I can't learn one from the other.
Says the Gemara, Nafkelei mit Rebbe. Like we say, Amar Rebbe, minayin lechamesh tevilot va'asara kiddushin shetovel kohen gadol umekadesh bo bayom tamud lomar pasuk bi ketone bat kodesh ilbash halamadata shekol mishane me'avoda la'avoda shetaun tevila. Rebbe's pasuk Ashkahan mi bigdei zav le bigdei lavan. I find when you're going to bigdei lavan, you're going to kodesh kodeshim.
Mi bigdei lavan le bigdei zav minayin. How do you know when you're going down? Tana de ber bishmael kavahomer. Mag de bigdei lavan shein kaparatam merubeh. You don't wear them all year. Teunim tevila you have to dip. Bigdei zav she kaparatam merubeh. En odin she teunim tevila. Lecha orai she need tevila feshul. Says Gemara ikel emifra. Mal bigdei lavan. Maybe that's why you need it. Maybe it's more hashuv. Meaning, when you go here, I tell you maybe that. When you go there, I go.
What do you have to keep? What do you have to keep? If the whole year round, the bigdei have doing the job, what do you have to keep? Unless it's a higher point.
No, it's a lower point. But I only need to do it once a year.
Lower point, what do I need it for? Again, for the second opinion.
Let me ask you a question. Which is more important, gasoline or an oil change?
Two different things.
I ask you, which is more important? I don't know, but you need an oil change once or twice a year. And more important, less important, what do I need for?
We're doing Yom Kippur, it's the holiest day.
Who told you?
Who told me?
Once a year, I have
to. Who told me?
When you make an oil change, yeah? When you put up gas, you have to open the trunk? You have to go lefnayv lefnim? No. When you make an oil change, you have to go lefnayv lefnim. You have to open up the trunk, the mata, right? I have to have the oath and that. So he says, I don't know, this is bifnim, this is bahut. It's I have to even talk like this, but, I don't want you to get sentimental over here. You don't know. You know which is more kadosh. Jimmy's been screaming, this one has the Shema Mefurash inside, this one doesn't. What do I know? This is kadosh. That's kadosh. This is kapara magurai. I'm mechaper every day. This one is Yom Kippur. You have Jews. They come to shul on Yom Kippur. They say, if I came Kippur, it covers me for the whole year. We don't believe that. But I come in a way. You go to shul every day. Guy missed Kippur. Right? He was in the hospital on Kippur. So you have his reformed cousin. He tells you, he's not better than you. I went to shul on Kippur. You do.
He comes back on.
Okay,
so you need this with this together.
You need both. And more or less, higher, lower. I don't know which is higher, lower. Each one has a higher and a lower. That's the point. Says the Gemara. Hadikatani.
Rabbi, without washing the hands, you can't put on the clothing.
We didn't touch washing the hands yet. Right now, we're just talking about dipping.
I'm saying which one's higher, which one's lower.
Both of them are the same.
Right.
Both
are the same. Without the other, it doesn't go.
The Omer Hainu de Katan. He says that's what Rebbe says. Rebbe wants to learn two from one, right? Rebbe wants to learn both limudim, switching from bigdei lavan to bigdei zav and bigdei zav to bigdei lavan. He wants to learn both of them. From Ketonet Bat Kodesh in the beginning. But maybe you only know when you're switching from Bigdei Zav to Bigdei Lavan. Hainu de Katani, that's where Rabbi says, Ve'omer, Bigdei Kodesh, Hem Verahat, Es Besaro, Bamayim, Ve'sham. Hare, that's extra. So what's it coming to teach you? Bigdei Kodesh is the same. The reason is not because it's Zahav to Lavan, or Lavan to Zahav. Bigdei Kodesh, on Yom Kippur, anytime you put on Bigdei Kodesh, you go to Mitzvah. Doesn't make a difference. So Rabbi's Dirasha, Bigdei Kodesh Hem, gives him a 2-for-1. Now he has the other Pasuk extra. Whereas according to the Yudah, didn't make such a Dirasha. Both Pasukim are busy being used for Tevila. One for Bigdei Zahav, one for Bigdei Lavan. Everybody keeping score here?
Okay.
Says the Gemara. So now the Gemara is quoting the Braita again. V'chamesh avedoten. There's five sets of avodah. Tamid shel shahar bebigdei zahav. Avodat hayom bebigdei lavan. Elo ve'elam bebigdei zahav. Kaf machta, taking him out from the kodesh kodeshim bebigdei lavan. Tamid shel ben arba'im bebigdei zahav. So therefore, because I have all those, I wind up if I have five putting ons of clothing, I need five tevilot. Every time you put on Bigdei Kodesh Yom Kippur, you need tevila.
It's going back to the same Bigdei Lavan, right?
No, they actually have a different set. Different set, yes. Uminayin, twice. Uminayin, shekol tevila ve'tevila tziricha bet kiddushin. So now I learn five tevilot. How do I know that every time needs bet kiddushin? Now, that's only true according to the Bimeir, right? According to the Chachamim, Sometimes you need two, and sometimes you need one. Tamud lomar, ufashat verahatz verahatz velavash. What do you mean? Haibet tevila ketiv. He's talking about tevila. Ufashat verahatz besaro b'mayim. He's talking about tevila. Men onyan letevila. Tenaf galem mibigdei kodesh hem. So who's talking? It's Rebbe. Rebbe learns all the tevila from bigdei kodesh. Tenei onyan lekidush. So put it by kidush. I don't need it for kiddush. I already learned kiddush from Big Day Kodesh Hem. So therefore, Pasha v'rachatz v'rachatz l'avash is talking about kiddush yadayim v'raglayim. Look in Rashi.
Don't you need it for Big Day Bat? Big Day Zahav?
No. According to Rabbi, I learned it from Big Day Kodesh Hem. All Big Day Kodesh need.
You need it for one. You're making two derashot from Pasuk.
I'm making two derashot from Pasuk. From Ketone Bat Kodesh.
But it's not just from Ketone Bat Kodesh.
It's only from Ketone. No. But it's all from that Pasuk. This Pasuk is totally clear according to Rabbi.
They got back on the plane.
Emeno enyan letevila denafkele mebigdei kodesh. Em teneu enyan lekidush. Says the Gemara. Velichte verachmana belashon kidush. Why doesn't the Torah write that he's washing his hands? Kidesh yadav v'raglav. Hakamash malam. It's a hekesh. The tevila kekidush. Ma kidush b'makom kadosh. Just like kidush always have to be b'makom kadosh. Kedichtibe, Rashi says. B'makom kadosh. אף תבילות הבאות מחמת מחלפות היום במקום קדוש. All the תבילות that come because of switching for today have to be במקום קדוש. No. The mikveh has to be in Azara. The first tevilah we said is the hall, and all four other ones are b'makom kadosh. So just like the key, now it's a little bit of a funny thing. Only in the switchings when you're switching from kodesh to kodesh, you need what's called b'makom kadosh. Aval tevilah rishona lo yalfa mine. Halav de oraita hi. I thought it is. Wow. It could be Rashi holds that when it says kol machlif me avoda la avoda, Rashi only learns that the four of them are deoraita, and the fifth one, what is only halacha la Moshe Misinai? What's that? The Pashtus is the Doraita.
Alachal Moshe Misinai say 5 and 10. So which means? According to Rabbi, right?
Now, the second guy is the second best seat in the house, and the third best seat is the bottom. You get the worst seat. That is the album.
Rashi threw us for a loop there. Okay, we have to investigate it. Says the Gemara.
Top is the best. If you don't go with this Kabbalah,
Rabbi Yudah, Kiddush Minale. Rabbi Yudah can learn Kiddush from Pasha Verahatz Verahatz Velavash because he's learning that Verahatz is Mikveh. Nafkilem with the Rabbi Rabbi Shimon. He learns it from Rabbi Elazar Rabbi Shimon, who made a kavah homer. If you don't have to dip, you have to wash. If you have to dip, certainly you have to wash. If so, right?
Practically speaking, it's not nice. It's not nice to scream in the
city. Let him call the second guy.
Amar of Chizda. Rav Chista says, Had Rabbi, Maafka mid Rabbi Meir, or Maafka mid Rabbanan. Rabbi's the Rashal, Pashav Rahatz Verahatz Velavash, doesn't go not like Rabbi, and not like the Chacham, not like Rabbi Meir, not like the Chachamim. Why? Because he's learning it. Each Verahatz is where it says it. Upashat Verahatz, after you take him off. Verahatz Velavash, before you put him on.
Why did other guy sit on top?
Now, Rebbe Meir holds Upasha Vilavash, yes. Vilavash, but then he holds not Vilahatz Vilavash, Vilavash Vilahatz. According to the Chachamim, it's wash, take off clothes, dip, put on clothes, wash. So according to the Chachamim, we said, that's what we said. Wash your hands.
No.
Wash your hands. Take off your clothes. Right. Go to the mikvah. Put on your clothes. Wash your hands.
Right.
According to Rabbi Meir, according to Rabbi, it's upashat verahatz, verahatz velavash.
Verahatz what? Verahatz yada veraglav or verahatz mikveh?
Yeah. No. Verahatz yada veraglav. Mikveh verahatz velavash. So according to Rabbi, all washing hands is when you are naked. Yeah.
Before.
Upashat verahatz, verahatz velavash. You're always naked. Right? Mafka, Pesach Gemara over here. Mafka mid Rabbi Meir, umafka mid Rabbanan. It goes against Rabbi Meir and it goes against Rabbanan. Why? The ilu Rabbanan amri kishu lavush mekadesh. They say you always wash your hands with clothes on. The Ihu and Rabbi Lechaora Amar Keshu Poshet Mikadesh. You have to put them on after you took off your clothes. Umafka mid Rabbi Meir. The Ilu Rabbi Meir Amar Hach Kiddush Batra, the second one, Keshu Lavush Mikadesh. You make the Kiddush at least after you put on your clothes. The Ihu Amar, and according to Rabbi, is Mashma Keshu Poshet Mikadesh. You make the Kiddush before you put on your clothes. Look at Rashi. Amar of Hizda. Kasavar of Hizda. Davka Amar Rebbe. Rebbe was specific when he says Upashat Verahatz Verahatz Vilavash. Meaning, Shene Kiddushin, the two washings of the hands, with the Verahatzes, then Peshita Vilavisha, are between the taking off and the putting on. So after you take off, you wash, you go to the mikvah, you wash again, and you put them on. Echalif Netevilav, Echala Harea, Kodim Levisha. So if that's the case, Mafka Midrabi Meir. Mutzeti Michlal Dvarav Shor Rabbi Meir. Meaning, Lo svira leke Rabbi Meir. Lavogav da amrin v'matnitim. Pashat v'kidesh yadav v'raglav. Even though Rebbe Meir holds that first he took off his clothes and then he washed his hands. The svira lay because he holds. Kiddush shelefnei tevila. The kiddush that you do before you dip. Ahar peshitahi is after you take off your clothes. Paliga le mia b'kiddusheni. He's still arguing in the second washing. The ka'amar ahar levishahu. He says it's after the levishah. Ki the katani braita derbi mi'ir le'el. Lavash kiddush yadav v'raglav. After he put on his clothes, he washed his hands. So Rav Chisda takes the derasha of Rabbi literally, and therefore he says that there's a three-way machloket tana'im when it comes to when to wash the hands. Rabbanan is always dressed. Rav Meir is one dressed, or one not dressed, then one dressed. And according to Rabbi, both undressed. Amar of Acha Bar Yaakov, no. He argues on Rav Chisda. Hakol Modim, even Rabbi agrees, Bil Kiddush Sheni, the second Kiddush, Shilovesh Veharkach Mekadesh. That first he puts on his clothes and then he gets dressed. Mai Ta'ama, what's the reason? The Amar Kera, the Pasuk says, O Begishtam Il HaMizbeach. Or when they come to the Mizbeach. It says by Kiddush Yadayim V'Raglayim, it says Bevu'am El Ohel Moed Yirhatsu Mayim V'Lo Yamutu O Begishtam El HaMizbeach L'Sharet L'Aktir Yishel Hashem. So it says O Begishtam El HaMizbeach Mi She'enu Mechusar El Gisha Yatsa Ze She'mechusar L'Visha V'Gisha. It says the Kiddush Yadayim V'Raglayim V'Avodah, and Hare the Kohen Gadol is doing it for Avodah, always has to be when you're ready for Avodah. Or Begishtam, you're ready to go to Mizbech. Guy's naked, he's not ready to go to Mizbech.
Also done by the Kiyom, no?
You need a Kli Kadosh, whatever the rule is. But it has to be dressed. That's ma'akeh. I'll have the Kohen Gadol wear a sheet until he gets to the kiyot.
You don't see that. You only see the boots.
They'll walk around him with the sheets. They'll have 10 people carrying sheets around the Kohen Gadol as he walks.
He has invisible portion.
Pinhas will make himself invisible. Okay. Amar le Rav Acha b'rei d'Rava le Rav Ashi. Lo Rav Chisda it le d'Rav Acha v'lo Rav Acha it le d'Rav Chisda. So Rav Chisda ken ol d'Rav Acha and Rav Acha ken ol d'Rav Chisda. Why? Because if you say that Rav Acha who says that you have to make it when you're dressed holds of Rav Chisda that you also have to make it when you're naked, or Rav Chisda who says you make it before you get dressed says you have to make it like Rav Acha when you're dressed, im ken, havlehu hamesar kiddushin. You're going to have to march 15 times. Undress, wash, dip, wash, dress, wash.
It's a song, no?
Then you have 15 kiddushin.
It's a song like that.
No, 15, 5 tevilot, 15 kiddushin. Why? Two naked, one dressed. So it can't be that they're on the same page. Hevi ulo etetamid keratzo. My keratzo. What's this word keratzo? Where do you get it from?
According to Rav Acha, he's...
If he holds a
Rav... Rabbi's like Rabbi Meir, or Rabbi's like...
Oh, Rabbi's like Rabbi Meir. Maybe not. Maybe he has some other derashat. Depends how literally you take it. Amar Ula, my keratzo. Amar Ula, lishna dekatlahi. It means kill it. Amar Rav Nachman bar Yitzchak, my kera. Where do we find in the pasuk that the term keretz is talking about killing? Egla yefefiyah Misraim. Misraim is a beautiful calf. Keretz mitzafon ba. The killing is coming from the north.
You,
you see the pasuk uses the term keretz. I don't know if that's the reason yet. I believe that many times the Chachamim talk with words from Tanakh, and they use them in order to teach you what those words mean. A lot of times they use the word aval to mean yes. Why? Because you have in Tanakh aval ben en la. Aval is yes. Not but, yes. Aval, yes. So they use that. So to over here, keratzo, you know what keretz means. It's also by Sarah, maybe. Aval, no, but it's by Sarah. Aval, Sarah, Ishtecha. So Aval is yes, Rashi says. In the end of Lech Lecha, when Hashem tells Avraham, Avraham says, Lu Yishmael Yechiel Lefanecha. Aval, Rashi says, Lashon Amitat Devarim, Bekushta. So Hazal use Aval, Bekushta, it's true. This guy, sometimes you have like a word that has a funny meaning and you use it all the time, like to remember that story. Aval, yeah, that's what it is. Sending Keretz, I think they use it like the unusual word. Yeah, but I don't know if that means the same. It's true, it's there. I don't know if it means yes. Aval Sarai Shtechaz Bekushta. I got mixed up with which one it was. Could be there too, I'm not sure. So he says, Keretz means so my mashma. Kedemetargem Rav Yosef. Malka Ya'eh Hava Mitzrayim. Mitzrayim is a beautiful kingdom. Amemin Ketolin. Killing nations. Mitzipuna Yetun Allah. From the north are going to come there. Keratzo Bekama. How much shechita did he make? Amar Ula Berov Shnayim. He shucks most of the two. Rashi. Hechsher shechita betzimtzum. The minimum that's kasher for shechita. Vechen Amar Yohanan Berov Shnayim. Minimum kasher l'shechita. Ve'amar resh, ve'af resh lakish savar berov shtayim. Ve'amar resh lakish, v'chi me'achar sheshaninu rubo shel echad kamohu. If you tell me already in the Mishnah and Holim that rov of one siman is like he shechted the whole siman, so what do you have to tell me rov of two siman is like two siman? Pashut. Lamash ad rov echad me'ov v'rov shtayim bebehema. Once I know that rubo kikulo, if just like it applies to one, it should apply to two simanim. So he says, "Lafish shaninu," because we learn. Heviulot etamid keratzo umireka heshechital yadovi kibelat adam zrako. Yachol, I might say, lo mirek, if the other guy didn't finish the shechita. Yeah, pasul, it'd be pasul, because you didn't shecht enough. You only shechted off shnayim. Says Gemara, yachol yom lo mirek, yeah, pasul. If the guy didn't finish, it'd be pasul. Im ken hav yele avoda be'aher. Then somebody else did avoda in Yom Kippur. V'tanan, and we learned, kol avodot yom kippurim enam kesherot elabo. Achi ka'amar. Yachol yeh pasul midrabanan. I might say that midrabanan the chachamim made a gezerah. That if you don't shech kol asimanim it's pasul. Lekach shaninu rov echad ve'of ve'rov shenayim bebehemah. Rashi mimishna yetera hada bechulim v'hada bekodashim. Mide ka'amar bishemon ben lakish telepirusha hach de seder yoma tenan la deshchitat chulim shmamina kiratzod acha ve'rov shenayim. Says Gemara, v'chi me'ahad, afilu psula drabanan leka. Snaim pasum drabanan. Lama li l'marek? Why do we have the other kohen finish the shechita? Mitzvah l'marek. It's a mitzvah to complete the shechita. Rashi, kedei lotzi et adam yafeh.
When you say you have to complete, what does that mean?
I think it means kol ha'shnayim.